who's faring best in the business world? Hello, I'm Susan Kennedy. Are large companies better able to handle the financial angst of this recession? Or are small businesses, lean and mean, poised best for growth in 2010? It's a new year, a new decade. Is it time for a new outlook on the economy? We talk with business owners, bankers, investors, and economists to find out what's ahead for the region's business base right now on Tempo Public Square.
Support for Tempo Public Square is provided by the members of PBS 39.
Layoffs, cost-cutting, failed loans, a credit crisis. It's likely most business owners are happy to say goodbye to last year's economic woes. But what's up for 2010? What types of businesses are best prepared for growth in this new year? What types of programs are best able to help those businesses thrive? Tempo Public Square's Grover Silcox reports that as business experts look into the future, many are cautious but optimistic about the economic road ahead.
Life was good. Cash and credit twinkled in the heavens. People looked up, thankful for their jobs, their homes, and their lifestyles. Then, in November 2008, it all came crashing down. Well, nearly. The global economy veered off into a black hole called the Great Recession. Large and small businesses, including those in the Lehigh Valley, felt the blow.
We sensed something wasn't quite right. It wasn't until November, however, when the market crashed, that we felt consumers rapidly pull back on their purchases.
It may take a couple of years or more to get back to the levels of activity we had in 2008.
Federal Reserve Chairman Ben Bernanke says the economy is now in a fragile recovery.
I think there's room to be optimistic, but there's also room to be pessimistic. And this is the hard part about macroeconomic forecasting is you never know.
Muhlenberg Economics Professor Don Dale may not see into the future, but he does see how this recession continues to impact businesses in different ways.
I think small businesses are having a tougher time in this particular recession than bigger businesses. And I think a lot of that is because small businesses are more dependent on bank lending.
Brett Baccio went to his longtime bank for a business loan and found that they had put a freeze on lending to companies in the housing and construction market.
We've been a great customer for at least 10 years. And we were shocked when the credit was not going to be available.
Brett's company, Kitchen Magic, has a 30-year history of handcrafting and resurfacing kitchen cabinets, installing countertops, and remodeling kitchens. They're a big, small business with 200 employees. Prior to the recession, they worked on 40 to 50 kitchens a week.
After October 15th or so, sales declined to about 30 to 40 kitchens per week.
Brett trimmed costs and reluctantly cut payroll. As business stabilized through 2009, he sought funds to purchase a new site for his company rather than continue renting. Ultimately, he got that loan with help from the Lehigh Valley Economic Development Corporation, Lafayette Ambassador Bank, and the Small Business Administration's 504B loan program.
The advantage with that program is that the borrower doesn't have to come up with the 20 to 25% down that's typically required when you're buying a commercial property. Hey, I got good news for you. We got your loan approved here on Tuesday morning at the loan committee.
The SBA type loans that are available are a small part of the puzzle, but they're very productive and they're available and they're going to keep cranking them out.
Does this signal the end of the Great Recession? Not just yet, according to Professor White Martindale of Lehigh University.
The last good forecaster was Joseph in the book of Genesis when he predicted the seven lean years. But he got the word directly from God. And we haven't had that ever since.
And yet, there's room for optimism.
There are some early signs of recovery. We're approaching this very cautiously.
Air Products, an $8 billion industrial gas company with global headquarters in the Lehigh Valley, got hit hard by the recession. According to newspaper reports, they cut more than 2,500 jobs worldwide and 400 locally.
And what happened when the economy turned off is really a lot of our customers immediately turned down the amount of products that they were buying from us. We had to make some immediate responses as a result of that.
Air Products implemented a continuous improvement program to streamline operations and cut costs. They also revved up development in Asia and other foreign markets. These strategies have helped stabilize their operations and prepare them for the next rising wave in the market.
We intend to stay a highly competitive, thriving industrial gas company. We're doing that by expanding globally, but maintaining our headquarters here in the Lehigh Valley.
Air Products employs about 4,500 people in the Lehigh Valley.
Air Products, or any big company, their job is to stay in business. But that's what their obligation is, to be here tomorrow.
Cousins Michael L. Dantes and Michael P. Dantes plan on serving customers at their two Copperhead grills well into the future. Their vision includes expanding to other locations beyond Allentown and Center Valley. That'll happen once the economy rebounds. Right now, they're running a tight ship.
In our culture, in our society, people are always going to go out. I don't think that's going to change. But it's just how often and how much they want to spend when they go out.
The cousins noticed that some customers came less frequently once the recession began. That, however, seems to be changing.
We are seeing some old faces that we weren't seeing as much of. So we're seeing people a little bit more often.
The cousins say they responded to the tough economy by tightening the operation without forsaking the quality of their food or the loyalty of their 150 employees.
I am really very proud of our company because we haven't had to let any of our people go. We come to work, we work hard every day, so do our people. And they're a big reason why we're successful.
I think that things will look up. I think anybody who thinks that things are fine now is kidding themselves. But I do think, as I said, the most important thing, I think, is coming together and bringing all resources to bear and making everybody aware that there are resources there that can help you.
The LVEDC has a wide array of resources to help people secure funding and support for their companies in the Lehigh Valley, even at this critical time.
We are very blessed in the Lehigh Valley area. We don't have gigantic unemployments. We don't have civil distress, upset problems like that. We didn't have great bubbles that burst. I think we're very, very fortunate and should be grateful.
So, is the economy emerging from that black hole? We might ask the world's leading economists or look to the stars. Either way, for now, the answer remains out of reach. For Temple Public Square, I'm Grover Silcox reporting.
Thanks so much, Grover, and that certainly gives us lots more to follow up on here. So joining me now is Phil Mittman, President and CEO of the Lehigh Valley Economic Development Corporation. Thanks so much for joining us.
Hi. Thank you, Susan.
Now, as the name of your company implies and describes, it's all about economic development, Phil, and you really, just for our viewers, your program, and it's going to be a short summary here, streamlines the relocation and expansion process for companies who are looking to grow here in the Valley. So in light of this recession that Grover's talking about, is there any growth? Is anything happening at the Economic Development Corporation? And what, if so, what types of companies are coming in and looking
to help? Yes, there is very positive activity. Let me say also that the regional cooperation and collaboration we have with the public elected officials and their staff and the private sector mm-hmm. is very strong. So the diversification of our businesses is what has given Forbes magazine the authority to say we are the Lehigh Valley is the 26th best positioned in the country to come out of this recession emerging strong.
And why do you think that is?
It's because we no longer count on just a couple of large businesses. The viewers would remember Mack Truck and Bethlehem Steel and those. It's much more diversified with healthcare and services, medical devices manufacturing. Education is strong here in the Lehigh Valley. Those all create jobs, and for us at Lehigh Valley Economic Development, we are paid to market the Lehigh Valley and help businesses retain their employees, expand their business, and we cover all those that I just mentioned in addition to many others. But the technology sector is getting stronger. Okay. Education has always been strong. Healthcare is our largest employer. So in Lehigh County and Northampton County, which LVEDC covers, mm-hmm. we now have in our financing department at LVEDC, we work with banks all the time. So when I hear banks aren't lending, that's a big generalization that just isn't true all the way around.
You've touched on a lot of stuff there, Phil, and I want to just step back and say, we were talking before we went on the air, what's a small business, what's a large business? Is it determined by the number of employees, or is it determined on revenue?
It's both. It's the number of employees. For example, Lehigh Valley and St. Luke's employ almost 20,000 employees total, and they've been stable. their businesses in the billions of dollars. So that's big. What's small business? Mm-hmm. It could be a jewelry business that I'd be familiar with. It might be doing a couple of million. It could be a business we have here, a plumbing business. They might be doing a million. Small business is many things. It can be from $500,000 to $1 million.
So we're talking, but who's doing best in your opinion? Who's still in contact with you, who's looking to grow, maybe buy some real estate, expand their businesses? Are they the smaller businesses that you're dealing with or the larger businesses?
I would say those that are buying real estate or looking to buy the real estate are still the larger companies that want a presence here in the Lehigh Valley. There are food and beverage companies with whom we work mm-hmm. at Lehigh Valley Economic, and they definitely are still looking to expand their footprint here. And oftentimes that's distribution and warehouse. Now, we don't focus on that, but we get those kinds of information. We really like to focus on the urban cores, and of course we get a lot of activity in the counties overall. For example, a couple of in we have Gillespie Printing, Bill Ellick Plumbing, Kitchen Magic, mm-hmm. and Backstage Library Works, an interesting business coming in from Utah. Now, they all came to LVDC to help with financing.
And
so we
piece,
work with those banks
right,
that
right.
help them, and we back it up with Small Business Administration loans, Small Business First loans, all kinds of 10 or 12 programs that we can do to help those banks guarantee those loans. And then those businesses can expand. And by the way, those four businesses I mentioned are almost 300 jobs retained or going forward.
And it really is about the jobs. I mean, we want the companies to do better, but you can't do better and get them better employees until you expand and until people spend money. Really.
Right.
I mean, it really has to start with the consumer out there spending the money so these companies can grow. The SBA loans, but you bring that up. There has been some criticism that that money isn't really getting out to the small businesses. In our piece at Kitchen Magic, they were looking around for a long time until they finally found a lender through SBA loans that could really help them out. And LVDC did help them out with that. What do you think are holding up? What are some of the problems that some of the companies are facing who aren't getting those loans? Is there something they're doing wrong or that they did wrong in the past year before this recession hit?
You know, I'm not in a position to judge what companies did wrong. I can tell you from my own business experience and political experience that, and I was on a bank board, today the standards that banks have are slightly higher, mm-hmm. or they are higher, than 4 or 5 years ago when everything was looking real good.
Right.
The banks had to tighten up the procedures. So, we've been working with companies that say, I want the $500,000 or $300,000. However, that the credit history of that borrower isn't as good as it needs to be. Or that borrower doesn't have the equity, the home ownership to put up as collateral. We must have collateral for my line of credit right. at home needed collateral.
Right.
And I'm sure yours did too. So the banks are doing a good deal. We all need to do more. And I would say that for the micro businesses, $100,000, $200,000 in revenue, they're working with Community Action Committee, Lehigh Valley, mm-hmm. the Rising Tide Loan Fund, and mm-hmm. so forth. We focus mostly on loans that are $100,000 and more, working with our banking partners here in the region.
And I noticed, and you had mentioned them before, that the library cataloging, for instance, they bought a building with that money. And also, I believe, the real estate company bought a building. Is that something that people should be, who are looking to expand, watching the show, and they're a business who might be able to access loans? Do you think it's really about building the building, the structure? Does that then in turn do the job growth? Or is it about the inventory of your business or dealing with employee taxes or real payroll taxes and things? What's the most important or maybe the top three things that these companies should be looking at to, if they indeed do get a loan?
First of all, they need to have their own financial. Any of us would need to have our own financial mm-hmm. house in order as a business owner. We must have the cash flow. What we find is the banks want to know what's the business plan, a professionally structured business plan that the business comes before the bank loan committee or LVEDC.
Right.
And that business plan will have it all laid out. Now at LVEDC, last year we started something called the Office of Minority and Women-Owned Businesses. And those businesses are usually 2 or 3 or 5 employees. And we help them get open. Our director, Eduardo Eichenwald, minority, women-owned businesses. And we helped in the Lehigh Valley 50 businesses get open. Now, the important thing is, can we sustain those businesses? How are those businesses going to keep going?
And how can they? And we are out of time. But already. It's so amazing to hear already. But it's amazing to hear what there is still growth amidst all of this. So
there
we really
is
appreciate
growth.
The update and on the businesses and the
projects
companies.
We have create over 2,000 or 3,000 jobs over the next 3 or 4 years.
Fabulous. Phil Mittman, President and CEO of the Lehigh Valley Economic Development Corporation. Thanks so much for being
here. Thanks, Susan.
All righty. Up next, where has all that money gone? A bank executive talks stimulus, cash loans, and business survival. We'll hear from him next. After more than 3 decades in the banking business, Dave Lobach knows his numbers. And after an economic year filled with bank bailouts, credit crises, and rising unemployment, the president of Embassy Bank shares how community banks, like his, fared better than a lot of those bigger banks. Here is his story.
Hello, my name is Dave Lobach. I'm chairman and CEO of Embassy Bank for the Lehigh Valley. And this is my story. Embassy Bank was very fortunate that we did not participate in any of the subprime lending or any subprime investments, and we didn't take any TARP money. We didn't earn it, we didn't deserve it, and we didn't want the taxpayers' money. So we were one of the banks, one of the community banks that stood up and refused to participate in that program. Some banks have decided to not to lend or not to lend to different market segments. But that's certainly not us. I believe you need to shop around, look at the community banks. They're very strong as a group. And I believe it's very important that you look at your banker as a partner and a resource. And don't hesitate to pick up the phone and get to know people like myself that are out there in the community. Many people are asking me today, is the recession over with? I believe that a lot of people are not feeling an end to the recession. There's still a lot of pain in the economy. We certainly have to create more jobs. We need to create more confidence to help to stimulate the economy. So we need to get more money into the pockets of individuals as well as businesses. As we look into the crystal ball, and certainly I'm not an economist, I'm a banker, we're hoping for a quick and prosperous recovery. We certainly hope that this happens sooner than later, and I have every confidence in the Lehigh Valley and our ability to recover and be the great community and great nation that we are. My name is Dave Lobach, and this is my story. Thank you.
Thanks so much for your thoughts, Dave. And from the business side to the small business side, rather from the banking side to the small business side, we now welcome Tony Iannelli to the set. Tony, thanks for being here. And of course, you are the CEO and president of the Greater Lehigh Valley Chamber of Commerce. 140,000 members strong. And what is that, 5,000 businesses, you said?
Yeah, 5,000 members and about 140,000 employees.
So how is everyone faring? What's happening?
Well, I think everyone's holding their breath. I mean, we had first and foremost, we've had a tremendous amount of expansion prior to this. So people were really, there were a lot of ills. Expansion hides a lot of ills. So businesses were continuing to grow, and life has changed. So I think the good news is, I think that in this past year, most businesses, particularly small businesses, have cut every bit of fat that they possibly can. And now if we start to see this mini expansion that we're seeing, I mean, maybe expansion's a little bit of an overstatement, but a little bit of growth that we're seeing, I think the good news is I think business is prepared to move forward with that.
Do you have numbers for us? What is a percentage of companies in your arsenal who may have had to close up shop in the past year during this recession?
Well, that's interesting because our retention from the Chamber's perspective has been consistent. So we really haven't lost that much in terms of membership. People have hung in. So I think we thought that maybe about what used to be maybe about 12% of businesses that would join, we'd lose just from the basic fact that they would close in their first year. That has maybe bumped to maybe 13 or 14, but we haven't seen. Now, life is pretty good comparatively in the Lehigh Valley, so we haven't seen a huge hit.
I'm surprised at those numbers because I think that since small businesses frequently are seen as running lean and mean, that with a bobble like the recession, they would have a lot more than just a few more percentage points would have occurred.
Yeah.
Why do you think it wasn't a bigger downturn for your members?
Well, I think, again, the good news, the bad news about small business, again, you're going to lose a certain percentage in the first year because, you know, maybe someone has a dream, maybe they're underfinanced.
Right.
The good news is they typically, the smaller business, typically doesn't have the burden in terms of cost that maybe some of the larger business. So they can sort of withstand the tough times. Now I'm talking about the very small business. You know, the medium small, if you will, maybe 30, 50 employees, you know, it's a harder hit for them. But surprisingly, most everyone has hung in to a great extent.
And before we go forward, you said the medium business, 30 to 50 employees, what is then a small business?
Well, well, that's a very moving target in this universe. We say 3 million and under in sales and 100 employees. So you know, again, you could talk to the SBA, they've got a different number.
Right.
So we throw those terms. Look, we say we have about 85% of our members are small business, and that's the category they fall in.
Now, this month, at the end of last year, the small business opinion optimism index, I believe it's called, didn't know there was one.
Okay.
Pretty darn gloomy. In 1982, in that recession, I guess the optimism index I read was below 90 for one quarter, but here apparently we're six quarters strong of always being below 90. So it tells me that, you know, your members are pretty disgruntled about what's happening, although, well, mainly why? I mean,
tells me you don't want to hang around with them right now?
Well, I guess not.
Well, look, I think two things. One of the things that we've gotten more heavily into is the legislative agenda, because I think not only are they being hit with the economy, but there's a lot of news coming out from a small business perspective that you're going to get hit again with more costs, whether it's card check legislation, employee free choice. That was a lot of concerns about that. A lot of concerns about the health care legislation. Certainly people were concerned about the bailouts and what that would how that would impact them. So I think that it's sort of a double hit, and that is that businesses shrinking for this short term period, and at the same time the potential cost that the on the governmental side could increase. So I think that makes for a little bit of pessimism.
If I'm a small business owner, what should I be really concerned about? What did I do right because I'm here today and I survived last year? And what should I be doing right in the future? Focusing on inventory, focusing on building, or just focusing on making sure I can pay my employees and really staying lean and mean? What do you say?
Yeah, I think what they did right was just that they were bold enough to make some tough choices. I mean, everyone's done it. We've done it at the Chamber. We've made some very tough choices.
Right.
We've had key people, myself included, make fairly substantial gifts back. So you've got to do what you got to do to make the numbers work to survive. I think going forward is you've got to reinvent yourself. And I know that's, you know, an easy statement to make. A lot of people are doing business electronically. There's a lot of social networking going on. And that's one of the things I've been really trying to remind our members, that the way, you know, I keep hearing, oh, nothing will ever replace the face-to-face. And yeah, most likely, but still, you better be aggressive with respect to how you market your business in the 21st century, which is entirely different than the way you did it in the 20th century.
And you're talking electronics, the Twittering, the Facebooking, the...
Absolutely.
And if you're not up to speed on that, where can your businesses go for help on helping with that?
Okay, just quick, we used to say our front door, obviously, we have a location in every city in Allentown, Bethlehem, Easton, and Phillipsburg.
Right.
So our office location was very key. That was our front door. Now our front door is our website. And many members we never see. About half of our members, they come on the website, they find out a lot about us, and they make that choice.
So, and you can join from there, too, I saw.
Yeah.
You just click right on.
So it's a different way of doing business.
We're talking about job growth, and it's really about employees. What about the SBA loans? Are you finding that your companies in your group are able to access those monies that are out there?
They're challenged. I mean, you know, that's the new thing out there, is the new issue out there is that banks are very tight and they're not loaning money, and they are very tight. The world has changed, and with the banking crisis, of course, everything tightened.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, and I have a differing opinion. I you know, we hear so much about, and on the large scale, it's one thing, but you know, a lot of people got into business. A lot of people bought homes during this time when things were a little easier. The credit issue was a little easier.
Right.
So I think it had some very good impacts. Now we got crazy, and the ripple effect was that we got into a lot of bad loans, and there was a ripple effect on lots of banks now on the national side. But what we say too is what the issues on Wall Street are different than the issues on Main Street. And Main Street, you know, we just heard from the piece from Embassy Bank, for instance.
Right.
Small community bank did it the old-fashioned way, balanced their numbers and so on, and stayed in business. So So, and again, the world's different when you're a huge institution, you're making major loans. So,
and also when you talk about small businesses, isn't it true that the school of thought that healthy businesses, if I just pick a pizza shop because I like pizza today, mm-hmm. if you're a healthy business and it's kind of this grumbling economy, isn't this the time for me as a business owner to go out there and bite my get my competitor, eat the market share? Is that still the school of thought in this type of an economy?
Well, but the good news, again, with the Valley, we've had so much growth that there's been room for almost everybody. Mm-hmm. And even in that period, from a national perspective, you almost could open up, if you were reasonably competent, you could almost open up any business and do fairly well because the expansion has been phenomenal.
It's good news in the Valley. Just this month in January, I pulled this article, too. The small business loans are apparently sometimes hard to get, but there are programs out there. Can people contact the Greater Lehigh Valley Chamber of Commerce to
find
out?
Well, we'll do very clear. We mm-hmm. do four things. We do business-to-business networking. We do legislative mm-hmm. agenda. We train, and we also have affinity programs, healthcare, and so on. So when it comes to loaning, that's where we're very clear. We shift them to the Economic Development Corporation.
Okay.
That's where we're going to find the funding sources. So we'll be a conduit.
Great. We are out of time, but also I want to remind our viewers, we'll have your website linked to our website so people can all get the help that they need. Thanks so much, Tony Iannelli, CEO and President of the Greater Lehigh Valley Chamber of Commerce. Thanks so much for being here.
Thank you.
All right, now how is your business faring as we turn to this new decade? What can your bank, your government, your employer do to help turn things around for a more prosperous new year? Please send me an email right here at publicsquare@wlvt.org. I'd love to hear your take and we'll get your comments on the air. Now next time on Tempo Public Square, customers light up over their choice of an electricity supplier. As rate caps expire January 1, more energy providers now vie for your business. What to look for in electricity and how to save money by using a lot less of it. Next time, right here on Tempo Public Square. We'll see you then.
Support for Tempo Public Square is provided by the members of PBS 39.